Hello children, today we are going to learn a new chapter in civics, chapter 2, Understanding Secularism, in this video 1. Chapter 2, Understanding Secularism. This is the intro for this chapter. History provides us with many examples of discrimination, exclusion and persecution on the grounds of religion. You may have read about how Jews were persecuted in Hitler's Germany and how several millions were killed. In all of the above examples, members of one religious community either persecute or discriminate against members of other religious communities. These acts of discrimination take place more easily when one religion is given official recognition by the state at the expense of other religions. Clearly, no one would wish to be discriminated against because of their religion, nor dominated by another religion. In India, can the state discriminate against citizens on the grounds of their religion? So the answer for that question is here. What is secularism? First, you have to know the meaning of secularism. The Indian Constitution allows individuals the freedom to live by their religious beliefs and practices as they interpret these. In keeping with this idea of religious freedom for all, India also adopted a strategy of separating the power of religion and the power of the state. Secularism refers to this separation of religion from the state. I think now you know the meaning of secularism. Here are the questions for this session. First question, who killed several millions of people? Second, in India, can the state discriminate against citizens on the grounds of their religion? Third, what is secularism? Fourth, imagine yourself as a Hindu or Muslim living in a part of the United States of America where Christian fundamentalism is very powerful. Suppose that despite being a US citizen, no one is willing to rent their house to you. How would this make you feel? The remaining topics of this lesson will be continued in video 2. Thank you, children.